to start off simply, a showreel is normally a video that sits at the top of your website, which showcases all of your best work that you've done to date. And it's an easy indication for a client to make a decision whether or not they want to hire you. Whilst making my own showreel, I got to learn a lot about what goes into them and the amount of work that you have to put into one in order to actually see its benefits. And I figured I would make this very short video to share all of the tips and advice that I received from other filmmakers, producers, and directors who gave me some really great criticism that I think more people should hear as well when applying it to their own showreels. So without further ado, I think let's start with the most important thing that I actually noticed myself and got criticized for as well, and that is the duration. This video cannot be long. It has to be short and snappy and quick to consume. You have to remember that the person that's watching this is probably also looking at a dozen other showreels on the same day, and you need to not only impress them with your work but also make their life a little bit easier. Don't make them wait around and sit for 3 minutes to look at all your clips. Instead, get to the point pretty quickly and try to convey as much as you can in as little time as possible. I think the best way to approach it, and this is advice that I actually got of a friend, is to treat it like a TV commercial. Every second matters, and you can't waste it on things that don't matter as much. Give the viewer or the client that's looking at your video, give them a reason to be wowed by it straight away. Don't waste their time or your time building these like really long and intricate introductions when you can just get straight into it. You need to make sure that the shots you show are the best of the best that you've ever done. That the shots that you show off in the video highlight who you are as a person, as a filmmaker, what your style is, and where your greatest talents lie, because after all, that is where you're going to book the most work. Don't include footage of nightclubs if you intend to shoot luxury commercials. It's a combination of the kind of work that you want to do down the line, so including footage from things that you don't particularly want to be booked for will only get you booked for those jobs. Of course, I understand as a filmmaker, sometimes you have to do work that you don't particularly enjoy, but it pays your bills. However, you shouldn't show that in a showreel, because at the end of the day, that's what will land you more jobs. And if you show that you're an event filmmaker, when in reality you want to be booking commercials and bigger clients, then unfortunately you'll only get booked for events, and it's just how it works. And I understand that not everyone has the footage that they want to show off already available in their bank. And I guess this is where the next point comes in. If you don't have a lot of footage, or if you don't have the kind of footage that you want to show off for the kind of work that you want to do down the line, this is where spec commercials and passion projects really come into play. You need to dedicate time to film the kind of videos that you want to be filming in the future, to have footage to show to clients that you've done this before and that you know what you're doing. By setting up all these spec projects and passion films and everything like that, not only do you get to have new footage for your own portfolio, but you also get to grow as a filmmaker. You learn new things and new ways to approach this work and this job, and you find new ways how to plan and produce and prepare yourself for these shoots, so that when the right client comes in, you can instantly wow them and you have the expertise for it. So don't wait around for someone to stumble across your work and give you a chance with it. Make that opportunity by shooting your own things, by shooting your own work, and then show it off. Show it off to people so that they know that this is what you can do and that you can do this and that they should trust you with it. Something I've kind of always actually struggled with since I started filmmaking and making videos is getting too emotionally attached to my own work. Sometimes a shot isn't the best in the world, but the emotional attachment that I have and the feeling that's connected to it is quite strong, and sometimes I find it very hard to let go. When you're making this, the clips that you are so emotionally connected to, they might not have the same impact to a client as you'd expect. So you need to make sure that the footage you do choose isn't connected to any emotions, and it's just pure skill and talent that you're showing off. Try not to use any tacky transitions. It's not 2015 anymore, and no one is unfamiliar with Zoom transitions and Luma phase. Instead, focus on the content in the video. And similarly actually goes with the color grading. Don't just throw on an M31 LUT and call it a day. Play with the colors. Try find a consistent palette to work with your video, but also try and show off the uniqueness of each clip. Get creative. Use black and white, use grain, and it's okay to experiment. You don't need to follow the same trends and rules that everyone has. Change the borders, change the aspect ratios. Just try to make it look somewhat different to what someone else might have. As humans, we associate music with feeling, and each song that we listen to can invoke a feeling in our minds that reminds us of a memory, or it might invite us to begin to dream about different things. And so the type of song that you pick, it's really important that it's true to you, but it's also true to the kind of work that you're showing. And of course, music isn't actually the only thing to do with audio. Use sound effects. You don't have to go too heavy with them, but use sound effects to give more life to your footage. So don't be afraid to add some whooshes, add some ambience, and build up a scene so that the viewer, even with their eyes closed, can almost imagine what the video is about without even needing to see it. And of course, sound effects, they help with that. So when you think that your video is done, believe me, it's not. It's actually still quite a few steps away. When you have your first draft ready, export it and send it to your friends. Get them to critique it and to be as honest as they possibly can. The reason why I'm asking you to do that and suggesting that you do it is because a fresh set of eyes can spot some things that you probably would have missed. And obviously, you're gonna have to swallow your pride with this one, because if the general consensus from everyone is saying that the song you picked sucks and you need to find a new one and make a new edit, well then swallow your pride, accept the fact that you're gonna have to make a new edit, and get it done. I really hope that someone who sees this video feels ever so slightly even inspired to go and look at their own existing reel and to just see where they can improve and where they can get better. Because after all, we're all artists, and even if we think we make the perfect project, it's never perfect. And we're always growing, and we're always learning new things, and we're always looking back at our own work and cringing and seeing different perspectives. So at the end of the day, if you even just picked up one thing, and that is to always be critical of what you do and just have fun with it. Try to be different, try to explore new things, and make them true to you. And if you can do that, then I think you're already winning. Thanks so much for watching. I'm gonna go home now because it's very cold and it's really windy. But this was fun, and I'll see you around. Bye.